Hi everyone, welcome to Lathus Kitchen. After watching this video, do subscribe to our channel and do press the bell icon. And if you like the video, do not forget to give us a like and do share it with your friends after watching this video. Today I'm sharing a very quick snack recipe, a very healthy snack I would say, without much of oil and much of masala and so on. A very good snack for a diabetic, because diabetic more often gets hunger due to their blood sugar levels. They need to eat, they need to divide their meal into five different portions, and they have to eat it frequent intervals. I know a few facts about diabetic because my husband is slightly on a borderline, so I kind of get into research on what all I could make and how do I keep his sugar level under control. Of course, I have posted earlier also many healthy recipes for men for diabetics. You may want to definitely take a look. Here is a sprouted chana dal quick bhel. To make a sprout, of course, you need to soak the chana for overnight, and the next day you can keep it in a strainer by draining out the water. Underneath, keep one vessel with the water in it and cover it, keep it in a dark place, and the next day you will see slightly sprouted, and if you leave it for even 24 more hours, you will get this nicely sprouted, the chana dal. It's very rich in protein, chana dal, compared to any other dal. So it's a very good option for diabetic. Just steam that by adding a little salt and keep that aside. Now I'm taking poha, green chili, red chili, turmeric powder, curry leaves, maybe some roasted chana dal also to add some crunch. Now take a kadai, add oil, add in half a tablespoon of turmeric powder and some curry leaves. Allow that to splutter. Once it is fried, add some green chilies and red chili. Depends on your spice, you can alter that. Then add in the poha, dry roast this. We are not adding too much oil, just a tablespoon of oil should be good enough. But you need to fry this poha. Keep it in a high flame without leaving it. Keep fry the poha along with the chilies and the curry leaves. You will see the poha change its color from light white to dark white, which is when you know that poha is roasted. You can as well bake this. So once poha is roasted, then add in the steamed sprouted chana dal. Ensure that it is dry. If it is wet, then the poha may turn soggy. Add in some amchur powder or a chaat masala. Keep roasting at it. Since you are keeping this on a high flame, ensure that you continuously stir at it, otherwise it may turn black. Once that is done, switch off the stove. Then add in the finely chopped onions and coriander leaves. You need not cook the onions, it has to be raw. So after switch off the stove, add in the raw onions. Raw onions you need to add while it is little warm, so that the little warm moist in the onions will get absorbed. Still it will remain. Crunch the bhel. A very healthy option for a diabetic. I say in particular for diabetic, because diabetics need healthy meal compared to any others, because of their sugar level. It needs equal amount of protein, equal amount of carbs and minerals and so on. This is a very healthy option for them to satisfy their small little hunger which they get at, if for a diabetic, if 8 o'clock is his or her breakfast time, then at around 11 they have to eat something. At that time, this can be a very good option to, satisfy his or her hunger. So just go ahead. Even otherwise, of course, it can be a very healthy snack for all of us. Do give it a try, friends. Let's eat healthy, stay healthy. Looking forward to hear from you on how you liked it. And do not forget to subscribe us and do share it with your friends. because good things should reach many people. Thank you so much for watching.